So we're going to talk about global buttons, and a lot of the time across all the websites we make, the CTA is largely the same. It's always the same, right? And normally you have a dark button and you have a light button, and this is quite universal, but sometimes you might want to change the button itself, or maybe you want to keep consistency across the entire website. And maybe sometimes it happens where you've got to change the CTA because the client said, hey, I want you to change this on all the pages. And you don't want to obviously manually do it on 50 pages. And this is where global buttons come in. So this one here, I've already set it as a global. I've just unlinked it. So what that means is I've gone into the widgets here in globals. I already have a hero button at the top here. And I've kind of, it's green. So when it's green, it means that it's a global button. And every time you make an edit to it, so every time you click on the edit button, that changes it for all the globals on the other pages. Now, all I've done to get this result is unlinked it. And then that way that it's, I can edit it manually. So I'll just delete this one just for the sake of example. And then what I want to do is I want to create one just temporarily for now. What I want to do is make sure that I add a white version that I can add throughout the entire website. But I need to make sure that it looks good on all devices. So what we need to do, it's got the same kind of CTA, like book free smile consult. That's fine. It's middle alignment for now. And I'm sure it's going to just adopt whatever I decide here. If I go align items, it's going to go wherever I tell it to. So I'm going to tell it to maintain the middle. And what I'll do is I'll just change the color quickly because I want to make sure that it looks like this and it's following adopting that standard. And so what we want to do is to make sure that we save this as a global. But before we do, we want to make sure that it looks great on all devices. It's positioned correctly. It's in the right spot. Sometimes you might be like, oh, we've got to do a left alignment on desktop, but on the mobile, it needs to be middle aligned. So you might be like, okay, well, we need to position it to the start, which is in the container settings, which it adopts it again. And then on mobile, you want to, you know, change the container settings there as well. Okay, so what we want to do, see what we've got here. This is the border width 22222. It's got the border radius, but this one here is different styling. So I'm just going to quickly adopt this, copy this, and revert it back to where it was. And then I'm going to make sure that that's white again. Sometimes this happens when you're trying to play around with different settings. That's fine. Okay, now it's got a border radius that we want. We just double check on all devices that it looks great. And sometimes in the back end, you might like align it to the middle and then save it and then go to the live version of the site and it goes to the left. And that's just the normal glitch that happens. And sometimes it's due to the alignment issues here and you just got to, you know, click out, click in again, and you should just be able to save it. So what we're going to do is we're going to save this, right? We're going to save this as a global. We're going to say CTA white middle, maybe. Maybe that's something that we can do. So I'll just save that. The naming convention is up to you. It's just gonna make sense for everyone that sees it, right? That's really the rule of thumb there. So if we go through, that's fine. It's in an okay position. I could probably close this gap a tiny bit so that they're at least closer and then double check that gap on all devices, right? So I'll just go like that. Cool. And now what you can do is you can simply find that global in here. We've got the mid and we can just pepper that in throughout different pages. So I might be like, okay, I wanna put one here. So at least that's better maybe, and then close that gap and then just double check on all devices that it looks good. I might want to go through here and say, okay, well, this is the old styling, this book appointment. And so I want to add in the hero version. So the darker and it's larger, it's what we want, book free smile console. And I want that below there, but I just need to double check that it looks good on all devices because sometimes the padding and styling is a little bit different and that's okay. So what I can see that looks fine for now. That's container. I might want to put a gap between the elements of 10. Oops, my... 10, no, might put a gap between the elements of 30, and then this one here, I might put a, okay, so they're the opposite direction, and so the quick way to do this is just reverse them, okay, so that's fine now, that's good, that's fixed, cool, so that looks good on all devices, so now this gap here, I feel like we need it like 30, maybe, or 40, looks a little better there, okay, and that's pretty much all you need to do, so you just save that, you clear the cache, so always clear the cache when you're making any large change, because a lot of the time, people that revisit it, like the client might revisit that page and not see the changes you've made. So I've just cleared the cache here. And then when you go back into it, you just revisit that if there's any issues with what you've done, whatever. But here I could replace it there as well, that same white styling. But yeah, that's pretty much everything there is to know about setting global buttons. But it applies to basically every kind of section type or element you can think of. So if you've got any questions, let me know. Thank